God is coming to be with you. Will you give your heart to Him? Will you give your time to Him? Will you, before taking decision, will you give your decision to Him? Ask Him, is it God's will? If you don't carry Him, if you don't give the life which He has given to us to Him, we will be robbed by the enemy. The Bible says, Proverbs chapter 8, verse 36 and 37, if you love the Lord, you will experience the love of the Lord abiding in you. If you miss Him, you will harm yourself. The moment you don't have His light, without your permission, darkness will enter into your life. The moment you don't give yourself into His hands and receive His courage and His faith, the enemy will bring fear, worries, discouragement, disappointment in your life, depression into your life. You may not be able to handle it. Don't throw away the light that comes to you. If you don't have Him, if you miss Him, when you don't have Him, the enemy will find a home in you. If you don't make your home for the Lord, the enemy will find your heart as his temple, and he will destroy your life. But if you give, God will use you. God will make you a gift to this broken world. Through all your brokenness, He will bring life out of you. The sword, people will be coming with a sword. God will make it into sickle. The destructive forces, with your destructive thinking, you will come to the Lord. With your fear, worries, anxiety, discouragement, you will be running to the Lord. The Lord will turn your spear into spade. Your destructive power into creative power, life-giving power. He will make you a solution to the broken world. Take care of what God has given to you. Your life is God's gift. And what you make out of your life is what you give it to God. If you don't give it to Him, the enemy will be playing havoc in your life. I was told a lorry driver and a cleaner, they were filling their tank with diesel. Two people were sitting and watching, like mechanics. They saw and they called this cleaner and the driver, your tank is full, your lorry is a new lorry. Can you give me 3 liters steel and give it to me? 3 liters of petrol, diesel, I will give you foreign liquor and chicken. The lorry driver and the cleaner, they stole 3 liters of diesel and gave it to these guys to get foreign liquor. They drank, ate the chicken, and they slept. When they got up next day morning, they found all the new tires of the new truck were disappeared. If you don't take care of what God has given to you, if you throw away your precious life, when they have thrown away the diesel, which is the master's gift, they have lost even the tires. If you don't take care of your precious life, problems will come. Till the end of our life, temptation will come, disturbances will come, evil will come. But God is saying, take my light and move with me. That's why in today's second reading, the Lord says, from the book of Romans, chapter 13, says, be take care of. Don't sleep. It is not the time to sleep. Be alert. Be in touch with your mind. What is happening to you? What kind of thoughts are ruling you? Be in touch with yourself. And awake, the Lord is coming. Give yourself into the protective hands, and He will make you a meaningful person. You will become a solution to the world. In the gospel, Jesus says, in the days of Noah, God spoke to Noah. Rain is going to come from heaven and prepare a boat that you and your family can be saved. Noah heard the voice of God and he obeyed the voice. The people laughed at him because Noah's house was 100 miles away from the sea. They laughed, rain will come. Because until then, the Bible says, the water was from down, from the rivers. The rain had not come. They said, how can the water remain there? If you throw a stone, it is coming down. How can water remain there? What is this rain? Being in the world, we don't understand what God has kept for us. Until we offer ourselves to Him, we don't learn to taste Him. We don't experience His power. In the absence of His power and presence, we are trying to adjust with the power that is available in the world, and we die with that. That is not our fate. A man was standing near a boy, and the boy was playing the balloon. The balloon was going up and up, and the boy was enjoying. And the man said to that boy, my son, do you see the balloon is going up and up? You are enjoying. Until the balloon takes care of what is inside the balloon, it will go high. The moment it loses what is inside, next moment it will be flat as a broken balloon. Take care of your heart. Take care of your heart and have the Lord with you. When Noah said about the rain, about God's word, nobody listened. They were eating, drinking. They thought this world is life. And suddenly one day, when Noah's boat was ready, God said, enter now. When he called the people, they all made fun of him. And the Bible says, God locked from outside. Suddenly drops of rain were falling. People looked up and said, what is this? From where this water is coming? One who is not walking with the word of God, one who has not learned to surrender oneself to God, will not know the power and glory of heaven. All they know is what is available in the world, and try to adjust with that, and being wounded with that, and die with that. God is calling. Your life is not only life on this earth. You have come from God. Build your life on the Lord. Close your eyes for a minute. All those people, they perished in the water. They were eating, drinking, earning money, busy with their lives. And they die with that, their busyness. You are created by God and for God. And only in Him you have life. Because He lives, you can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all your fear will be banished. You will have problems, but your God will show the way where there is no way. God is coming to be with you. He's inviting you to give your heart to Him. If you invest your time with His word, His thoughts will transform your thoughts. His thoughts will give courage to your thoughts, new light to your thoughts. If you invest your time for Him, to understand what's happening in your life, what does the Lord do in your life, why does the Lord allow these things in your life, He will use you as a solution. You are not a problem. Only the candle that has the light can lit the candles which has no light. Your family is in need of God. Your office is in need of God. Wherever you go, there are problems. People cheat you. People disturb you. People want to exploit you. Don't get upset with that. You carry God's light and be a blessing to yourself and to the broken world. Because He lives, you will live.